Yo, what's up, Paradise fams? It's your boy, Rim. We are excited today because it is our first wedding ever. And I'm very excited because I've always wanted to do one of these, and I have a feeling I might turn into a wedding DJ in the future. So this is a good practice. This one's not too many people. I think it's like around 80 guests, and it's actually an Indian / Bollywood wedding. So that's another challenge. Not only is it my first wedding, but it's a very cultural one, and the programming will be very strict. I have to really keep up with the timing, introduce people accordingly, and you know, all of that comes with a lot of preparation. So I practice a lot, set my cues, and even practice my speeches or my introductions. Other than that, honestly, you just gotta go with the flow. It's gonna be about 5 hours. There will be prayers in between. Like I said, it's cultural, so that'll be pretty cool. I'll try to get as much footage as I can, since this one's gonna be very interesting, and I hope you guys will learn from it, and hopefully we don't make too many mistakes and everything goes as planned. Thank you guys for tuning in and supporting my channel. Let's do this. Yo, before I head out, I just realized I'm actually really hungry, and get yourselves a wife that actually supports this hobby / gig. So and here we are. She made me some Japanese sausages and just some eggs with rice, and even packed in a Tupperware. You know, she always comes in clutch. Love you, honey. All right, guys, we're ready to go. I just gassed up, and here I am in the car listening to what I might be playing later tonight, a bunch of Indian and Bollywood music. Honestly, they're bangers, and I can't wait to play them and see how the people will react. Yo guys, we finally made it. It was a pretty nice drive, not much traffic. This is at a residence, and it's a pretty dang big backyard, so it's gonna feel like a large venue, even with, you know, not so many people, maybe less than 100, but I'm gonna try to fill it up, and it's outdoors, and so I'm gonna try to fill it up with all the music. It's time to meet the family and the people, so yeah, let's do this. This is everything I'll pretty much need for this gig. It's all unpacked from the car now. As usual, I set up my folding table first. That way I can put my controller case on it, and any mixers, microphones, any hardware, and as well as just have a place for me to start putting stuff on top. Next, I set up my microphone stand because it takes a little bit more room. I'm about to set up my facade, and I had to be very careful because it was actually pretty windy. It actually kept toppling over and scaring some of the guests. Now I'm setting up my light T-bar and my speaker stands or tripods. Now I'm pulling wire throughout the venue, which was kind of in a rectangular shape. It was a little awkward. Luckily, I had about 50 to 100 feet of RCA wires that allowed me to connect to my speakers, on top of connecting to the off-site generator that was about 200 feet away, so I was very fortunate to have enough wires to reach it. I've been getting a lot of comments on my past gig logs telling me to pull my speakers a little bit more inward, but for this gig I really needed to have a speaker facing the audience, especially where the bride and groom will be entering. And it didn't really help that my booth was offset by the swimming pool. Yo, what's up guys? We're finally done setting up. You can hear the music playing in the background. It's just the really chill Indian music, more like not really poppy or bangers, but just really chill, more prayer like. I got dressed in like 5 minutes. I try to look as nice as possible since some of that tension will be on me, you know. I put the DJ booth a little bit off to the side, but kind of in front. And I spread out the speakers just to fill the room, or I guess the venue, which is the backyard. All right guys, we're getting ready to have the groom and the bride enter. And we're gonna be announcing them and queuing up their songs. Other than that, yeah, I think we're ready to get the party started. So we're still waiting on the groom to actually make his entrance. But in the meantime, I'm playing some background music. But now we're ready, so I'm about to cut off the current song and cue in his entrance song.
At this point, we have the groom finally seated, and now we just have to wait for the bride. So I actually have the bride's sister help me with assisting in MCing, since she kind of knows the program a little bit better than I do, and she can actually address her crowd, especially since they speak a different language. So we're still waiting for the bride to come out, but in the meantime, I'm gonna take this opportunity to take some decent pictures of my setup for my Instagram and website. Here's some b-roll for you guys of the setup right now. If you like the content, make sure you share, like, and subscribe. I really appreciate all the support and all the love I'm getting from the DJ community. It's also been a very fun experience showing people what I do, even if they're not DJs and they just want to see these gigs for themselves.
They're just staying where they're seated.
I was very careful on how the bride was supposed to enter, especially since this is a cultural wedding, and I want to make sure if the guests are supposed to be sitting or standing, and I wanted to consider and be respectful to any traditions.
Are we standing?
And now that it's clarified, I am going to get on the mic and get everyone pumped up.
Alright guys, who's ready to meet the bride? Make some noise! Come on, louder so she can hear you. Come on now. Louder, louder.
I think that went pretty well for the second time around. So now we're ready to meet the bride as I cue her song in. I'm increasing the master volume, especially since this is the main attraction of the night and we want this to hit hard and hit home. Now we finally see the beautiful bride as she makes her way to her seat next to her groom. It's really nice to have wireless microphones, especially since this is a really weird and awkward layout with the swimming pool in the way. And so I was able to make it work, and it was actually windy, so I would try to make sure there was no clipping and the sound traveled throughout the entire venue. So it seems like the microphone is going in and out, and apparently my cheap microphones are just not cutting it. I feel really bad since this is my first time really using them, and I did not get an upgrade in time for this gig. But definitely these are one of those things that you just learn and, you know, hopefully you can improve on for future gigs. I handed them the other wireless microphone, hoping that would solve the issue, but what I really should have done was point the antennas to where the speakers are. I didn't even realize that, as I was actually low-key panicking, especially since this is a very important part of the program and we barely started, people are not really hearing correctly. I felt so bad here. It also didn't help that the person that was speaking was kind of talking away from the microphone, and I felt so bad because the people weren't really hearing his message. At least the bride and the groom were right next to him and they were able to hear his message clearly. So now we're done with that opening ceremony and we're gonna get ready to do the ring and the cake cutting. I have specific songs queued up for this part of the program, and I'm doing my best to monitor the sound, just hoping that these microphones don't go in and out. it was nice to have the specific song request for this part of the program, especially since this is a very important part and the bride and the groom are familiar with it. Now we're moving parts of our setup to the front yard of the venue because we'll be having a cocktail hour.
Alright guys, so this is the part of the night where we have cocktail hour and appetizers. So I got my laptop with me and my charger. I'll be moving to the front. I have a mic there and a second portable setup. I'll have about an hour set, so I'm pretty excited for that. We'll get to play more bangers and more jumpy and poppy music. So yeah, I'm gonna go over there now and start my set. And I think the religious ceremonies and the ring exchanges and everything turned out pretty well. People came up to me a lot, just telling me to turn down music, something's wrong with the mics, whatever. But I delivered, I think, and people enjoyed themselves. So, all right, on to the next.
So now I'm playing a little bit more upbeat music, and I gotta be careful here because people actually are lining up next to my setup, and I'm on a slope in the grass. I ended up having to bring one of my speakers to the front with me, which is fine since it's pretty light and portable. This is a great time to finally get some food in our system, have a little bit of a drink, and prepare ourselves for the rest of the night. We don't really know how long it'll be and what we'll need to do, but we might not be able to eat. Here I'm trying to eat and DJ at the same time. Maybe is a new skill that I've learned because of this gig. So the sun is pretty much setting and the cocktail hour is dying down as people are heading back to the backyard. It didn't really seem like a full hour since we were a little bit behind in all of the ceremonies, and I believe it went into the cocktail hour timing. But nevertheless, it's time to start packing up and head to the backyard where the rest of the programming will continue. I believe they just had their prayer around 6 or 6:30 p.m. So now I can play music again in the backyard as people are making their way back over there. Now I'm starting to set up lights since it is getting darker and it's starting to show now. I'm also monitoring the sound as people are making their speeches and toasts. I ended up having some dead air here after the speeches and people are starting to line up for the dinner, but I think I kind of save it just in time, playing some upbeat music as people are making their way. I'm just trying to get in the zone of playing some music in the background and actually mixing. So now the dinner portion is done and people are lining up for a special performance. So far I've learned that part of DJing is being a very versatile professional, and what I mean is this mix was actually prepared by one of the guests, but they didn't even have it on a CD or flash drive or anything, so I had them text the digital file over to me through WhatsApp as I'm actually trying to work the rest of the wedding, and I had it all prepared on my phone and lined into my mixer. I'm just glad it actually worked out okay and nothing, you know, was disrupted for the special performance. Monitoring my phone, especially since I haven't heard this mix ever, and it's actually sound coming from a portable player. I'm just glad it actually turned out okay and that we can continue with the special performance. I'm gonna get on the mic here to hype up the crowd and keep the party going. Whoever's whistling like that also happens to be my honorary hype man. So they're about 6 minutes into this performance and you could tell they're getting tired, so it's my time to shine and save them.
All right guys, what'd you think of that? Yeah, make some noise one more time for our performers. Woo!
Now we actually have another pre-mix that I've never heard of, and I just gotta do my best on the fly to make it sound decent and queued up. Very interesting and a very memorable experience for me to witness people dancing like this in a whole totally different culture for me. I think that was one too many horns.
Alright, one more time for iconic duo!
So we've got a little bit more performances here from the same two individuals earlier, and I'm doing my best to just keep the hype going. People have been sitting around for a little too long.
Come on, clap your hands. Let's go, everyone. Right here, right here.
So we definitely had to cut off these special performances, and I do my best to transition into the dance floor. I'm already getting my first song request from the bride's best friend. She's requesting Drake, but I'm kind of wary to play it at this type of event. But here I am mixing to another funky and jumpy song. Here I'm getting bombarded to play faster and mix faster, and also start playing some Indian music. I mean, given that this is literally my first couple songs, I just do my best at this point. It also doesn't help that the lights are full blast and I'm trying to set the party mood with the disco lights. It's nice to see people get down. And as I'm preparing for the next track and mixing as fast as I can. I haven't really listened to these songs and I'm just doing my best to set my cues and transitions on the fly. I'm trying my hardest to pay attention to the waveforms, looking for a possible breakdown and a good way to enter with a new song. It was also very helpful to have a playlist from Spotify sent over by the bride and the groom. Here's another transition from a chorus to a build-up in the intro of another song that's actually pretty hype. This is a great time to post on my IG stories for great memories. It's really great to see more people on the dance floor, and I'm doing my best to mix faster and introduce more songs, especially at the request of the bridesmaids. Here I applied to a pretty cool flanger effect build up to the chorus. And now I'm mixing into the next song. So I was actually happy that people were enjoying this genre of music, but it did have explicit content and I felt bad since this is a cultural wedding, but I don't think anyone really noticed. So this lady was very patient as I was trying my best to mix, and she just really wanted to tell me to turn the speaker that was on my left hand side in towards the rest of the crowd. Now I'm starting to realize it's really time to upgrade my speakers as I'm getting more gigs and becoming more of a professional, I'd say. You can even hear them clipping right now, but hopefully future gigs I can upgrade and fix this. Don't forget to hydrate. Look at those people on the side really getting hyped. I love it. I'm very happy to see the bride and the groom enjoy their special night. So that pretty much wraps it up for our first Indian / Bollywood wedding. Thanks again, Paradise fans, for tuning in and giving me much love, man, for all your support. Share, like, and subscribe if you like my content, and leave some comments below and let me know what you thought of this gig and how I can further improve myself. I know I learned a lot, and I hope you guys took something from my experience. I put a lot of work into putting this together, so keep tuning in. I'll be looking to put more of these gig logs out. But for now, make sure you guys take care of yourselves and keep grinding for your paradise. Peace out.